So I'm putting myself in your good hands to read. No holes barred. I'm a very transparent guy.
Yeah.
So go ahead.
Okay. So there's a few things that some people experience, they told me. They feel heat, right? They feel cold. They can also feel electricity. So this is all the energy that I'm actually trying to communicate with whatever in your body or whatever energy that may surround you. Okay, it might be good, it might be bad. Things have happened badly before, but hopefully it'll be good. Of course, it happened badly once before, and I tried this a few times. 9 out of 10, always good.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, let's make sure my hand's not sweaty. Yeah, you don't want to do that.
My hand's sweaty.
So, okay. So, I just need one of your hand. Okay, we're going to do a simple like handshake style.
Okay.
Right? I just want you to focus on the energy that resides around you while I do mine. Okay?
Is anyone here? What did you find?
You are listening to Supernatural Confessions.
Okay. So what I can sense of, right, I can tell a person is really good, right, and Eugene is bona fide good guy. Okay? But here's the interesting thing about you. I can feel something is like lurking around you. It's not really your guardian per se. It's not some, because you mentioned you don't keep any of this, right? So it's something that maybe is attracted to you, but it is a female entity, right? It is not Miss P. It's like a almost like a Bunian. Because she looks very traditional, like Malay traditional, like Indonesian traditional lady, right? She has a crown over her head, right? Very beautiful lady. But from what I can feel, right, it's nothing terrible, but at the same time, you have to be careful because these entities can fall in love with you and they can actually push your spouse away. So just to bear in mind, maybe you walk to a certain place, they happen to like your energy. It may not be you necessarily. That's why in Islamic belief, right, when we are in the restroom or when we are in the bedroom, whatever, try not to expose yourself too much, because sometimes these jinns happen to walk past by your house. They happen to see your naked body. They happen to like what they see. They happen to be attached to you.
Well, well, well.
This
they
is for
like
whatever.
What they see.
Or sometimes they just feel like they have the need to protect you. Sometimes it also goes by that. So it is hard to decipher what they want. Like, I just feel like maybe the merits that you do has caught their attention, because they like to be surrounded by good people in nature. Not necessarily you must be Muslim. No, no such thing. Any human can attract any of this. You just don't know it. Okay, for the first experience I have with the supernatural world, right, is where I start to have weird dreams. Dreams that you cannot explain. There's no logic in those dreams. There's just nothing. And one of those dreams, right, that I know that this is supernatural or the hantu, is where I was punching the entity, right, and I was choking it. So when I woke up, right, I was in the same position holding down the pillow and then punching it. That happened to my wife, because she happened to be caught in the crossfire when that Miss P, right, I saw, she was laughing at me, and I was like wondering, this never happened before. When I punched an entity in the dream, right, when I tried to fight it, they always show me the fear, the sense of like, oh no, I'm gonna die. And then when she laughs, right, I don't understand. Then when I woke up, I hear my voice saying, right, it's me, open your eyes. So I believe, right, she cast a trick on me to blind me and punching my wife instead. So that is a horrible trick passed on. So even someone as myself who has years of experience with it, right, can be blind to this entity who have been here much longer than we human have, and they have mastered every element possible. About one experience that happened quite recently, about like last year, okay, me and my colleagues, right, together with my wife, we are having this fun trip at JB, you know, Airbnb, living the life, enjoy from the stress-free world of Singapore, right? And then, sure enough, the next day, the morning day, my friend was grabbing a cup of coffee, and then the girlfriend take photo of him, okay? It was 8 a.m., mind you, and she saw like a silhouette of a pochong beside him. It's a silhouette because we actually try to brighten up the contrast, play with the saturation whatsoever, just to see the figure clearly, right? So we saw that. And then I told my wife and our friends that when we are going to do this Airbnb, and this Airbnb, right, is just beside the, it's just nearby the Malaysia Custom at JB. It's just right beside only, very close by. I said that I felt something not right. The Miss P is around, the Pochong also is around, right? It's around this area. But sure enough, on that day, I also felt that I attracted something that shouldn't be attracted. Something came. Passing by happened to came and almost take possession of our friend. When we bring her out to with more people, we thought like, okay, there's more people, more positive vibes. This thing will go away naturally. It doesn't. Whatever she eats, she vomits out. She has this constant anxiety and fear. She feels that something is beside her, whispering to her. And when I bless the water, right, while submerging the Traskelo, okay, when they say that you submerge the Kayu for quite a minute of time, and then you recite the prayers, and then you bless it, blow it very gently, you already bless the water ready, and you let the victim drink sip by sip, not a full gulp, but sip by sip. This is to make her vomit and to make her get rid of the thing within her body. And if you vomit something black, that means it's either a black magic or a black entity, right? But in this case, right, her whole arm over here grows very hot and a scar appears. Yes, and I was attacked with my friend when we were ordering food, right? So we want to go down to the lobby, and then while waiting at the lobby, right, the lift came very slow. It's almost like time stood still. My leg, my foot got grabbed by an unknown force, and I just couldn't imagine what was that. Like, I cannot tell whether it's Miss P or the Pochong or whatever entity, right? I know it was grabbed by something. And then once the lift is finally open, we went to the lift, right? My friend noticed, right, he keep pressing the close button. No, it's the first time that happened to us. The lift does not close, and this happened for longer than 10 minutes. And we all know in Singapore, if you're stuck in the lift, if it doesn't want to close, it makes a lot of noise and then eventually close, right, as a safety precaution. No noise, no nothing, just be open for the 10 minutes or longer. Then I recite the Ayatul Kursi, right? I make a prayer and I ask God, please get this thing out of here, because I feel like something is like holding the door like this. And then sure enough, right, once I recite the prayers, I just throw like that, right, to the leaf, and then the door just suddenly closed really quickly, like as if like something was holding it all this time. So when we were able to go down, right, I tell my friend, okay, once we go down, quickly get out of here, right, I'm going to recite more prayers because it's coming down to find us again. So sure enough, right, we quickly get the food, right, we are like Scooby-Doo and friends already, I quickly run around to get the stuff ready. We go back to the same leaf. My friend was like asking me, should we try another leaf? Okay, I can, maybe the other leaf, not so, yeah. And sure enough, right, the leaf door don't want to close again.
Again,
different lift. It's a different lobby. What the one that we went through is the closest to us because you want to go down fast, right? The next one we go down is further down the hall, right? It takes at least about 1 or 2 minutes away to walk. That's how far it is. And then when we go up over there, I recite the prayers again, right? The door closed really quickly. No sound, no nothing. And when I mention this to the guards, right, they say this never happens. Never happens. So when you said about in one of our Friday Night Live about belief, right, I was like, hey, what you just say is true, because I felt that too. And it's not just him, I'm sure other people also felt the same. It's just that they may not realize it yet, right? If you believe, it actually will happen and it will help to protect you. So the sense of belief is really important. That's why successful people are successful, because they believe they will make it one day. Why some people don't make it, they believe that, you know, this life is meant for them in this way, so nothing moves. So that's where I believe the power of the energy of the mind comes to you. I believe Guru Murali also mentioned about this, right? Belief is so strong. So the power of the mind, guys, it's very supernatural. It's all within us, right? It's just that we don't know it, we don't see it. We just want, okay, here's a magical stone from this one old uncle lah. I'm gonna have superpowers, guys. Or some people, like my NS friend say, right, I want to have this stone because a bullet can never penetrate through my skin. They want all this like kebal lah. Kebal in Malay, guys, it means invisibility from all any objects possible. But trust me, it's not gonna work or whatsoever. How I know, I actually tried, right? They say last time this metallic ring, they call it batu lightning stone. They call it this lightning stone have this healing properties to make your skin to be very hard, like a steel. So I tried, like, okay, I'm gonna try. It never worked last year. It's like macam fake. I can see the blood dripping. Then my dad was like looking at me, what are you doing? I'm like, this thing say kebal man, so I want to try, like I want to know. Then he's like, that's not how it works, you stupid guy, that's not how it works. So how it works is, right, it will come to you naturally when you're at most danger, when your life depends on it. That is what I understand. And you can ask any wise Malay practitioners, right, they will tell you the same thing. My son was keep having nightmares. He keep screaming, no, don't want. Abba, got monster. He wake up, he always immediately find me. And then he told me, got monster over there. And then what happened was, right, I told him, okay, no, go back to sleep. I'm going to help you, okay? Go back to sleep. Daddy's here. So I pray over my son. I tell the thing, the entity who's ever disturbing my son, right? And if you guys are wondering, can you tell entities? To a certain extent, like I can see what they are, but not what type. Every jinn has a type. Some are water, some are fire, some are earth, some is all rounder, right? So for this one, I believe it came from a fire, right? Because it is very strong, it's very potent. Because when I ask it shortly and I cleanse my son, I go to the kitchen to make myself a cup of coffee, and I hear two loud knocks like on my window. So I was like wondering what the heck was that. Okay, I was like telling myself, never mind. And sure enough, I go inside my room, right? I hear a tap water open. So when I went out of the room, right, the tap water was gushing open. So I was like asking myself, did I open this tap water? Maybe, maybe not. And I just closed back. I never think too much. But it happened out of the ordinary. Something that I cannot debunk. I don't know if I got to tell you this. Have I messaged you this, Eugene, where a friend, a neutral friend of us came to our home in Bedok, right? He also got learned what I learned, right? He also practiced the white magic that I practiced. It made my wife faint because our energy, the auras we were emitting, right? It was too great. My wife faint because she sees too many colors, right? Coming out from our body. And what I saw from my friend, right, it was more surreal because it never happened to me before. The room and every environment around me transferred over. We are in the jungle and he's a royalty. It's a royalty type of jinn that holds a special grace. It's all plated with gold, right? So I will ask my friend, do you have this guardian with you? Then he said, yes. How you know? I force it out. Then my friend also never thought that I could do it, right? So he let his guard down. I actually forced it. I said, with the name of Allah, right, if you're really there, come out. So whenever when you say the name of God, right, they will always come out. I know this is more like a Hollywood story with the power of Jesus, I'm able to compel you, right? It actually holds true, you know, it actually holds true to that extent. And then when that happens, right, he showed me that he has a master in Indonesia who taught him all these things while they are out and about in a jungle. So it's so crazy, so surreal. And then when it happens, right, he also saw my the thing that is believed to be protecting me. He saw that what I have is equally strong, but at the same time, right, I was almost fainted because when I did that, right, my head was tilting back like this, and then suddenly I came to my mind, right, like, hey, I don't want to faint. I don't want to lose. So I gain back the energy coming back for my body, right? And I come back and I make him feel that he needs to faint. So this is also another way to say scanning battle, where you exchange energy, right? We see who's the weaker one, who will faint. Yeah. So that happened. And sure enough, funny enough, right, when we were doing it very intensely, right, my wife is the first one to faint. She's like, I want to vomit. And then she actually go to the toilet and vomit. She feels so sick afterwards. Then ever since then, me and our mutual friend, not gonna name him, right? He laughed, he smiled, and he's been a good friend of us ever since. We met during the circuit breaker times. So during circuit breaker, we did something we're not supposed to. We go out in the middle of the night, try to adventure, find ghosts, right? So I told initially my wife, please don't follow them because they like people who are afraid. That is where they can come to you. You are afraid, you have lack of faith. This is all part of the requirements for them to take part of your body. It's not as easy one would think. They have certain conditions must be met. So once those conditions met, right, they're able to take you on easily. So when we are over there at Pasir Ris Park, right, in the middle of the night, Suicide Tower, it was so dark. There's no wind, right? But there was a swing, right? And the swing just moved by itself. And all four of us, right, we see. One of my friend, he liked to bloat, right, that he learned traditional silat from a Malaysian master, right, who embedded with a spiritual practices that can kill a jinn or any entity with the martial art performed in the proper manner, right? But when you see him do it in real life, it's actually very funny. He was like, huh, huh. So I was like, come on, I learned all these things, right? My dad don't ask me to, huh, huh, but I can understand what he's trying to do. If you're able to see if you have a third eye, right, you're able to see sometimes a fire might come out from his hand or this if they are doing it properly. Okay, so what happened is he goes over there, he actually like very howling, he go to the ghost like, I can whack you. And he saw a Pontianak, right, actually at a tree, and the thing was laughing at him. No? He was like, you don't laugh, you come down here, I can whack you. I learned this thing. He's like, I was like, what are you doing? You are going to their house, right? You uninvited, you're being rude. You have no respect, and because of that, right, it actually stirs the other entities around us. And some of them even come to my wife and whisper in her ear. It was a lady, you know, very seductive, low voice, right? And then I feel like someone was playing with her hair, and I have to stand behind her to make sure nothing comes behind her. Sometimes possession comes in, right, from the back, the neck area, commonly known from the toe. That's why you also can remove certain entity from the toe for Malay practitioners, right? When you take an egg, when you from head to the toe, and then when you crack it, there's something black happens. Yeah, you can actually trap it from there. You can squeeze the big toe, right, the ibu jari, to inflict pain and tell it leave, and that's where it will leave. All right, but you also must recite prayers, lah. Right, these are all certain conditions must be met again. So I go behind her, I cover her the back of her neck, all right, and I feel it's very hot. It's strangely hot. So I tell the spirits like, please don't bother my wife. She did not come here like to bother you. She just come here to experience the atmosphere, right? She's here as a guest. And then meanwhile, my friend in the background like, you come down here. And then sure enough, right, when we had our feel, because his girlfriend was telling, because his girlfriend got third eye, right, telling, right, please stop, you are angering a lot of things, right, and they are following us. And then when we go to a HDB block right nearby, just outside of the Suicide Tower area, the Pasir Ris Park there, right, we heard, right, Pontianak laughing, and it gets closer, closer, and closer. So we felt like, okay, this is something not cool, And then we quickly book a Grab, right, and then go off. The mistake that we do, right, we straight go home. We thought that we hang out a certain area, right, for 10 minutes or so is good enough. At first, I scan the area, everything's clear, until I feel like something's coming. I ask my wife, quickly book, something's coming. And then when we are in the taxi, right, I saw it was actually flying beside the car, the taxi car. Then it was laughing, you know. And then shortly enough, I thought we lost it, no? Because the taxi, you know why, they drive in a very weird way, like rounding and rounding. I think we thought we lost the Pontianak, you know. Then we come back home at Bedok, right, where everybody had a short stay over there, right? And then my wife and her friend want to cook. So what happened is, when they are cooking, right, my wife heard a lady, because she asked a friend, hey, nice, not I cook. Then she suddenly heard, not from her, but from her, the entity that says, like as if like someone sniffing, like, Nice, something like that, right? And then she got so freaked out because her friend was beside her, and she's like, "Did you say that?" And then she's like, "No, I did not." And then they both run to the room, right, and telling me like, "Hey, I heard something outside door, something outside door." And then my friend, he's able to see like Miss P walking past by, you know, like in the living room and you have the windows, right, at the outside lobby corridor. You are able to he's able to see the Pontianak walking like that. Then I was like, why you guys can see, I cannot see. For some reason at that point I cannot see. I really cannot see. Then I was like, wait first, let me try to scan the area to see where is that thing. And then my friend asked, where is it, because he was in his silat fighting mode. I was like, the thing is over here now. Then move, it's over here, its back is flying across. It doesn't want me to pinpoint the exact location. And then when I able to see the face, like the pure face of Miss P, like it was very horrible, very scary face. And I asked, why are you bothering us? He say, I come not for you, not for your not for the girls, but your friend, the guy. He dared me in a way that I cannot back down. I come here for revenge. I want to put him in his place. If you interfere, you will get it too. That's what it says. For what I understand, right, this is a universal law as well. My dad says that if it has nothing to do with you, let the case go. Right? You are able to ask the thing to go off after it's done. It's easier. Right? So true enough, right, call me a coward if you will. I did not interfere. Right? So my friend actually got hurt really bad at his shin, right shin, right? He felt something kick him really, really hard. And then at the same time, I heard a laughter and the laughter goes away. And sure enough, the thing left. And then he was limping. I laughed at him. I was like, you see, who asked you to dare? See, where's your silat? You see, instead of you burn, you cannot slap. See, never ever dare an entity, guys. No matter how good you think you are, right? Don't dare it. You're going to get it happen. And then when we thought he was playing around, right? The next day, it was really swollen. You can see at the near to the shin bone area, right? It was really swollen, like as if he's doing a Thai practicing kicks. So he was like telling me in Malay, "Asyik lah Pontianak tu. I come here to whack it. Ini I kena whack." When you want to ask a jinn to make a pact with you, especially the most effectively possible, you got to do things right that will.
Listening to Supernatural Confessions.